Good day, good day, beautiful beings. Journey, part six. This morning. So right now I'm in Chicoutimi. I'm gonna go back. I'm going to go to the animal store, and I'm gonna go and make some, you know, some customized little necklaces for my two cats. For, let's say they would, you know, accidentally get out of the house or whatever, right? So at least they'll have the number of my friend and their name on it and everything, like the ones they already have. You know, just some extra precautions just in case. So let's go and make some little, you know, necklaces for my babies. Necklaces are done. So I got one for Mimi, my oldest, and got one nice one for Max, my youngest. Let's do this.
Miss you. I'm gonna miss you.
Okay. Oh, I'm gonna miss her. Little baby. I'm gonna miss you. Gonna miss you. Hello back, my beautiful beings. Welcome back, welcome back. So today let's talk a little bit about some updates, what happened to me and some struggles I've been going through too. So here you go, let's start. So I just left my friend Joseph, Chicoutimi, Quebec, in direction back to home, Cornwall, Ontario, for the last week I have my home. And basically, you know, I've been having some issues for a couple of years now, but basically the dealership for my car was supposed to have solved this problem. This problem is still going on. Basically, my car overheats, my motor overheats for an issue. They've been looking and, you know, testing my car and everything, and all, no errors, everything is fine. So anyways, they changed my oil and everything, and basically after, like, you know, 40 minutes to like an hour sometimes, or 2 hours depending, my car will overheat and I have to stop on the side of the road, and I have a lot of road to do, a lot of travels, and I don't want to, you know, make my motor explode, but at the same time it's kind of frustrating, right? Because my car keeps overheating for an issue that was supposed to be solved before I was past the warranty of my car. So that's one of the biggest struggles I've been going through lately. You know, the way I see it, it's like it's the universe's way to actually teach me a lot of patience. So right now I'll have to take my car off of cruise control, and every time I go up hills or whatever, I'm gonna have to drop down to like maybe 80 kilometers an hour or something to make sure I don't go past too much, like 3,000 turns per minute, RPM, my car. Because when I go too much around like 3,000, 4,000 RPM for like maybe 5 minutes or something, boom, it overheats, I have to stop on the side. So I still have, you know, I have like, I'm kind of restricted in time to actually drop all my stuff to different family members, which are like very far apart. And I'm also gonna have to try to sell this car. So yeah, that's the struggle I've been going through. But so I left, I tried to be there around like 6 p.m. to be right there for my last meditation session with all the the people from the spiritual center. I don't even know if I'm going to be able to be there. I'm already not going to be there on time. So hopefully I won't be there too late, but I wanted to, yeah, to attend one last session with, you know, my local spiritual people in my town of Cornwall at the shop called Healing Wishes. You know, just amazing people there. So yeah, also now some, so that's, yeah, so it teaches me a lot of patience. When I do my last trip, I might have to stop a lot of time on the side of the road to drop everything and try to make, because like I had a lot of unexpected things that happened, so I'm not as well off financially as I originally thought. I'm gonna have some money eventually coming in for my pension that I'm taking and everything, but I won't. So let's touch on the pension. So my military pension, I did the biggest sacrifice ever. A lot of people would say like, man, you crazy, like why would you spit on that pension? You worked for it, your country owes it to you, right? So what happens is that they give me a couple choices, right? So I have the choice of either taking the lifetime pension, because I've done over 10 years in the military and I can have the life pension for life if I want to, but only when I start to be at 60, like a check of like $1,000 the rest of my life. Or I take what's called a transfer of value, which is basically pay you a lump sum, but you renounce your lifetime pension. And it's not exactly the same. So you either have to invest it wisely, or you know, you got to be very careful, because if you spend it, then you know, you've lost your pension for life. But what happens is that what really motivated my decision into not renouncing my pension, but like, you know, taking the transfer value, which is pretty much renouncing my pension for life, because I'm trying to actually break from the matrix. I'm trying to break from the system. That's one of my worst nightmares, to be honest, when you think about it. Like, to be dependent, you know, dependent upon the state by a check, and then they could, you know, try to, you know, to make me do things against my will, otherwise I won't get the check, or, you know, I could imagine all types of negative scenarios, you know, that could happen, especially after everything that's been happening since the pandemic. You know, a lot of shady things have been happening. People's rights have been trampled on and everything. So I wouldn't be surprised if they tried some similar things in the future. So I was just like, you know what? And also it aligns with my will to completely detach from the matrix. And it's also the, as much as possible anyways. So it's a big sacrifice I'm making. I'm renouncing my pension for life in the military to taking a lump sum. And since the stock market has dropped so much, I've lost pretty much everything. Like they're going to give me maybe $15,000 to $20,000 versus I would have a check of $1,000 the rest of my life. You know, like I'm losing a lot of money doing that. But guess what? I don't care about money. I only care about my values and following my values. And my values is to not support this system. So I might as well take my money out of it. You know what I mean? Even if I lost most of it in value, I'm going to use it to fuel my travels, fuel my dreams, and that's what's most important to me right now. It's not that important, to be honest. Now, second thing I wanted to talk about. Basically, I had a great conversation with my brother the other day, and basically it was like, because I'm like, oh, you know, I might want to keep my queen size bed with my mattress because it was expensive that I bought a couple years ago and everything. And he told me, like, why are you trying to keep that? Why are you trying to keep still certain furniture? Like, you should sell everything. Like, you're about to embark a new chapter of your life. What's the point of keeping it? Because my thought originally was, well, I don't know when's the next time I'm going to have the means to actually pay this kind of an expensive bed. So once I sell it, I might never be able to get that much comfort ever again. But I got to be okay to renounce my comfort in the future. So I'm going to be trying to sell my bed. I'm going to probably put it in a storage unit for like 1 month, because I don't want to pay for many months, just for 1 month to transfer to empty my house completely, try to sell the rest of it and drop the other stuff to my family's place. So yeah. So I guess I'm going to be cutting off even more furniture that I wanted to keep originally, and it's going to help to, you know, to put more and more trust into the universe and less weight pulling me down. So yeah. That's kind of the gist of it. Let's continue the journey. So my friends, have a beautiful day. Stay blessed. And I'm going to try to not have too much issues with my car. But that's just the issue I'm having right now. And I'm going to keep having it until I actually sell my car. So it is what it is. And the universe is teaching me patience. So it teaches me a lot of patience and to control my emotions even more and to not get angry at the situation. Everything happens for a reason, and the more you humble yourself with the present moment, with your current circumstances, you don't focus too much on the future or the past or whatever, right? Well, everything's going to always get better, and you don't have to let all these unfortunate circumstances that affects your personal life to trigger you. You can look at them from a third-person perspective, but you don't, you know, it's not necessary, like, your state of being is always a choice, a personal choice. If you want to feel good, you're going to feel good. If you want to feel like crap, you're going to feel like crap. But that's always your choice. So, yeah, just wanted to bring this up, my friends. So have a beautiful day. And I'm going to try to be careful with my car, with the gas pedal, even more careful, just to make sure it doesn't overheat. So have a great day and much blessings, my friends. May the journey prosper. We'll be right back.